वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू वन एंड ऑल. आई एम अमन कुमार एंड अंडर ग्रेजुएट स्टूडेंट परसुइंग बीएससी ऑनर्स इन फॉरेस्ट साइंस फ्रॉम गलगोटियास यूनिवर्सिटी. आई एम गोइंग टू रिप्रेजेंट माई टॉपिक फॉर टूडे पोस्टर प्रेजेंटेशन, दैट इज आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ 3D टूल मार्क्स. सो बेसिकली आर टूल मार्क्स इज एन इम्प्रेशन, स्क्रैच और एब्रेशन मेड व्हेन अ कॉन्टैक्ट अकर बिटवीन अ टूल एंड ऑब्जेक्ट. टूल मार्क्स कैन बी लिंक्ड टू अ टूल यूज्ड एट अ क्राइम सीन and ultimately may be used to help find out that suspect who use it. A tool can be used in a commission of crime. They can aid criminal in gaining entire or damaging property. Whether tool are used, they can leave behind marks on the surface. They contact examiner in a firearms and tool section can help solve a crime by linking any tool marks. So, the identification of a tool marks using light comparison microscope, Leica FSC, is discussed. Three-dimensional tool marks that have resulted in expanding the scope of investigator to resolve the crime. Forensic physics have shown rapid advancement in the production of various techniques that help in identification of 3D tool marks, that relating them to suspected tools. Techniques such as 3D printer like Tevo Tarantula, naked eye photography of tool marks using Leica M205C stereo microscopic comparison microscope, silicon casting are used for identification of 3D tool marks. So let's be discuss about material and methodology. So we required suspected tools first, and second is object encounter with a tool, and third one is thixotropic elastic casting material, and fourth is Leica FSC comparison light microscope, and fifth is tool scan 3D scanning device. So methodology, the primary step is as usual the examination of crime scene thoroughly and collecting the evidence which are to be subjected for tool marks identification. The collection of suspected tool is equally important for comparison of tools with the tool marks. And first is identification of tools or weapons. If initially a weapon is seized, the very next step is to prove the reliability of our attacking weapons. And second is primary microscopic examination. The weapon has to be passed through various medical legal examination. One of the major examinations is comparison of the tool marks with the tool itself. The tool is primarily subjected to a microscopic analysis in order to check the minute irregularity in the surface. And the third is very important. If a tool impression on a body part, the autopsy examination is essential in order to check the incision, cut, depth, roughness of the tool impressions. And the fifth is tool marks, marking and casting. The tool marks are present on the softer body, soft body tissues, muscular layers, or bone cartilage. And these tool marks has to be marked or labeled for identification and observation under a comparison of light microscopic. All the test marks are then recovered by casting material, which also help in estimating an orientation of tools or the weapons. Fifth, casting of comparison of cast marks using light comparison microscope. The entire cast marks are examined using Leica FSC comparison light microscopy with the help of oblique lighting. The microscope details of the cast with the help of oblique lighting with a microscope detail of test marks and regularities present on the tools. So there are many more methods which help for identification of 3D tool marks. First is optical comparison of 3D scan marks, and second is computational comparison of 3D scan marks. The cast of marks produced by light microscopic comparison are scanned using tool scan, which is forensic 3D scanning. And computational comparison of 3D scan marks is used for comparison of marks and test marks by using 3D scanner processor, which help in identifying the outlier of the tool marks. So the result or discussion is the mentioned techniques for the identification of 3D tool marks have resulted into a solvation of various criminal cases in which the identification and comparison of tool marks with the suspected tool. And the one of the most famous case study is Sharp Force Trauma with two katana squad. The entire case was based on the identification of tool marks on the skulls. And the conclusion is casts are made on the bone surface which had been subjected to the crime weapon. There are various methods used in order to perform examination of 3D tool marks. This has become an advancement to the investigator in forensic scientist, as each tool marks carries a unique character and significance. It tells you about this situation and it helps in the reconstruction of what would you have happened during the crime was committed. And that's it.